Look at you, you sexy tiger.
You know, I've been so wrapped up in making this a perfect day, giving Jessica this dream wedding. I haven't really had a chance to thank you properly for all the help you've given me.
Properly? As in a blowjob? Hand job?
Huh? I'm seriously, man. You've always had my back. You know, you stuck up for me when I was teased in school, when I was going through bad times, and now you're going to be standing by me on my wedding day. So I'm just trying to say thanks for being the best man ever.
I am the best man ever.
Cheers, man.
Yeah.
You know what was the best? You finding a replacement for the band so quickly. I mean, I can't believe they bailed. Jessica was super pissed off.
Yeah, I can't believe that either.
That's perfect.
Come in.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Corinne.
Hi, Corinne. Hi.
So, the last guests have arrived, and they're just taking their seats.
Perfect.
If you guys need anything at all, I'll be right outside the door, and I will come and let you know when it's time.
Awesome. Thanks, Corinne.
Yeah, thanks. Corinne, thank you.
It's Corinne.
Oh. Well, she fucking wants me, dude.
Whatever, dude.
Good lord.
I was just talking to the groom. Uh-huh. Oh, that's true. No, let me check.
There are a ton of women at this wedding, and I am ready to go.
Great.
And boom.
The D? Are those fucking dick pills?
Yeah.
What are you gonna do with those?
Well, it's a wedding, right?
Last I checked.
Yeah, so I'm gonna get drunk. And I don't know about you, but when I get drunk, I get a little soft. So I pop two of those and suddenly it's the one-eyed homewrecker. And then I'm all like, you know, like, get right up here. And I'm like,
get off me, you weirdo.
Okay. No, I'll let them know. Perfect.
Oh, fuck.
Just one more thing.
Oh, fuck.
Never mind. It's not a big deal.
It's not what you think.
No, it is.
Welcome to Stanley and Jessica's wedding.
Stanley? What the fuck is this?
The tailor must have fucked things up.
How? You gave him my measurements, right?
Yeah.
34 waist, 30 length.
Yeah, that's what I gave him.
Then how could this have happened? How am I fitting into it? There's a kitchenette in this thing.
Okay, look, I have a confession to make. I don't want bad karma today. I was in a bit of a rush when I went to the tux place, and I forgot to bring the measurements you wrote down, so I just kind of wrote something down from memory.
When have I ever been this big, man?
I don't know a lot about waist sizes.
You're screwing me here. How am I going to get laid?
You could impress the ladies with a dramatic weight loss story.
This is some sort of funny joke, man? This whole thing is really funny to you?
No. Look, I'm sorry, man, okay?
It doesn't matter. Really, it's... whatever. It's water under the bridge.
Thanks, man.
I'm still gonna look like a wedding asshole, though. But I also have a confession to make.
Okay.
Well, the band didn't bail. Yeah, I've had a lot on my mind too, you know, with planning the bachelor party and all the wedding duties. I kind of forgot to book them and they booked somewhere else.
Dude, if you felt overwhelmed, you could have told me. I would have taken stuff off your plate.
Yeah, I know, but I didn't want to let you down.
Look, what's done is done. Honestly, the DJ's gonna be great.
Totally, yeah. Just because he's a strip club DJ does not mean he's not a pro.
He's a fucking strip club DJ?
He's all I could find last minute.
Wow. You know what? If the fucking clown pants and the strip club DJ are the worst things that happened on my wedding day, you know what? They're nothing in comparison to the nightmares that led up to it.
So we're cool?
You tell me.
Of course, bro. Boom, 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 boom.
You know, man, I like that we're being honest with each other. You know, like, I never meant to keep secrets from you.
Yeah, me neither.
Maybe if... I don't know, we're hiding anything else. We should just let it all out. We should come clean.
Yeah, I mean, if there's anything else at all.
Maybe, you know, one or two things.
Okay. Go for it.
Okay, this isn't wedding related or anything recent, but... You remember in grade 9 you had that chemistry assignment due and you lost it? You know, the day you're supposed to hand it in is worth like half your mark?
Yes.
You remember how I wasn't so great at chemistry?
Uh-huh.
Look, I borrowed it from your bag to copy it over lunch and I spilled cream soda on it and ruined the thing.
You dirty rat. I had to go to summer school because of you.
I felt bad. I felt really bad.
Whatever. It was so long ago. But if we are going back that far... I got one, too.
Okay, let's go back. Go for it.
Remember that summer you used to have all your sleepovers at your house?
Yeah.
And I would sleep in between your bed and the dresser.
Yeah.
And your mom kept bitching about how all your socks were going missing?
Yeah.
Well, when you go to sleep, I jerk off, and the sock drawer was right there.
Wait, you jerk off right beside me?
Yeah, you were asleep.
And into my socks?
I mean, dude, I always jerked off into socks when I was a teenager. Especially yours. So soft.
Okay, we're talking sleepovers. One time you were sleeping over at my place, I knocked your toothbrush in the toilet. I put it back on the sink, should have thrown it out in hindsight, but, you know, before I could tell you, you were brushing your teeth with it.
Oh, you let me brush my teeth with a poop brush? Ew.
Honest accident.
Oh, that's disgusting.
A bit overdramatic.
Do you remember Laura Myers?
Yeah, I remember Laura Myers, the girl that I had the biggest crush on in high school, who wouldn't give me the time of day. I remember Laura Myers.
Yeah, I never told you, but I also had a crush on her.
Oh.
Yeah. One day during lunch, I sat down next to her and tried talking to her, but she kept asking me questions about you. I got a little jealous, so...
So what?
She kept asking me about what you were doing that weekend. And I told her... that you were grounded because your mom walked in on you and caught you spread eagle getting peanut butter licked off your balls by your dog.
What?
Yeah.
You're telling me you're the cause of everyone in high school calling me Mr. Peanut and fucking peanut butter balls? Canine and peanut butter ball witch and Snoop Doggy lick my balls and Snoop Doggy butter balls and Dog the Boner Hunter Mutt Sack and fucking Scooby Dooby Blue?
Yeah. I didn't think it was going to become this huge rumor, though, so I'm sorry about that.
This is so messed up. And to think that Laura Myers was into me. I could have dated the hottest girl in high school.
Yeah.
You remember when you found out that Donna had been cheating on you for almost a year?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I knew about that 6 months before because I set up her and Eduardo.
Mm-mm. No, hold on a second. Are you fucking kidding me?
I actually introduced her to Eduardo. Yeah, bro was in my English class and helped me with my resume, so when she needed help, I, you know, sent some numbers across and... Hey, I didn't know they'd start boning.
No, but you didn't know and you didn't tell me. Dude, you're supposed to tell your best friend if his girl's cheating. That is fucking bro code.
I honestly didn't know what to do. I felt responsible because...
No, I fucking loved her, man. You didn't tell me. You knew that.
Yeah, and you know, I didn't know you'd be the cause of my whole high school torment.
Okay. At least now everything's out in the open and we can start the healing process.
No more secrets.
Well,
Yeah,
there is one more thing.
One more thing.
I banged your mom.
You banged my mom?
You fucking killed Puffy?
You banged my mom?
You killed Puffy!
Bro, you banged my mom?
Bro, you killed Puffy! I'm gonna knock your teeth into your butt.
Sorry about Poppy, man. Look, your mom, forced me to take some of that fruitcake she made, and no one was looking, I threw it in the fireplace, and I didn't think the dog would dive in after it.
Oh. I've always thought he committed suicide because he hated Christmas. You know what? Don't worry about it. It was a stupid dog. He was bound to do something dumb.
I know you loved him, man.
Yeah, I did.
I felt horrible. I still do.
Dude, I feel horrible. I banged your mom. I mean, it only lasted like 10 seconds because she would do the same.
All right. I don't need the details, please.
Sorry.
Flirt with all my friends. Of course, I'd be stuck with the hot mom.
Yeah, you did.
Well, she'd have banged anyone. Glad it was you.
Thanks. I mean, to be perfectly honest, I thought it was your sister. It was so dark, and I was shit-faced, so...
Are we cool?
What are you telling me? Alright. I don't think this is gonna... There you go. Okay, yeah, whatever, man.
Bring it in.
Alright, let's do it.
Alright, it's about time.
Love you, dude.
Thanks, man.
Yeah. All right, let's get you married. Corinne, are you?
What? I'm done.
Call me.
Let's get this guy married, too.
Be afraid to get up to the rail, I mean the dance floor, and just shake it like you own it. Don't forget about your waitstaff. Tipping is not a city in China. The Bride and groom can always use a little extra help, so pull out that wallet and make it rain. And don't forget to tip your DJ.